Oke. Oke. Ya. Oke, lipid metabolism ya. Yeah. So, in lipid metabolism we will study about two part, catabolism or degradation of lipid. So, how the lipid that we eat will be degrade into energy. Or secondly, biosynthesis. So, we also conduct biosynthesis of lipid in our body. For example, like if you eat excess amount of carbohydrate, the carbohydrate in our body will be converted into lipid. You eat large amount of protein, so the body will only use some part of those excess protein. The rest will be converted also become lipid or fat. Yeah. So that is the biosynthesis and catabolism of lipid. But however, other than the major lipid in our body, for example, like that we store in our adipose tissue, in our stomach, in our cheek, yeah. Also, there is a synthesis of important lipid. I will discuss this later, because, for example, like hormones, yeah, it's also a part of the lipid, and steroid hormone play an important role in our life. Yeah, for example, like growth hormone. Yeah, many of the growth hormone are steroid hormone. Include sex hormones like testosterone in male, estrogen. All of those are steroid hormone. Other than that, also vitamin D. In today's COVID pandemic, vitamin D is a very important to us for survive against the coronavirus disease. So the vitamin D sources, there are two vitamin D sources. First, from our diet. And secondly, we can synthesize vitamin D in our body with the help of sunlight. But sunlight is an energy, it's not a molecule. So sunlight will act as energy to convert cholesterol in our skin become vitamin D. The reaction is a bit complex, it involves many molecule and precursor. But anyway, the vitamin D synthesis start from cholesterol. So that the cholesterol is not that bad. We need cholesterol, especially small children need cholesterol, because those children are still in the growth period of time, and for the new cell to be synthesized, cell membrane need cholesterol. So the cholesterol is not bad for everybody. Cholesterol is bad especially for the people who have become aged. Yeah, because if we already reach our adulthood, yeah, we don't need that many cell synthesis. If we push the cell synthesis, we push the synthesis of new cell membrane, then our cell will become bigger, or our cell will become more and more in number, and that's why we will become more fat, yeah, because we synthesize new cell, we make the cell bigger. And that's actually not good. But in small children, they need cholesterol because they have to synthesize new cells. Okay, so about first lipid biological function. Main function of lipid. I think there's a slide before this. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Main function of lipid is to store the energy, energy storage. Yeah, lipid is energy storage. Second, pigments. Many pigments are synthesized from lipids. For example, like xanthin, yeah, in animals, it act in human as antioxidant. So, for example, like vitamin A, it's also a derivative of lipid. Next, cofactor. Many cofactor come from lipid. For example, like this inositol triphosphate. This is a cofactor for an enzyme. It's a lipid derivative. Hormone, such as testosterone, it's a lipid. The people that lack of lipid consumption, for example, like those who get a malnutrition in some part of the world, yeah, it's difficult for them to synthesize lipids. And hormone also. That's why their growth will be retarded because they don't get enough essential lipid in their daily diet. Cellular membrane. As I stated previously, our cell membrane consists of lipid, include phospholipid and cholesterol. If we lack of phospholipid and cholesterol, we cannot synthesize new cells. That's why children need lipid intake, yeah, in the form of free fatty acid, yeah, especially unsaturated fatty acid is very healthy for children, and also some cholesterol. Next, extracellular and intracellular messenger. This is inositol 3-phosphate is a kind of intracellular messenger. Okay, this is some of the lipid biological function. First, we talk about storage energy. So lipid can act as energy sources. The 1/3 of our body energy come from triacylglycerol. So in normal diet, for example, like common students, male students need about 2,000 calories daily. Female student needs smaller, about 1,500 until 1,800 calorie daily. About 1/3 of those energy come from lipid. So if you eat something, yeah, it's good for you to get carbohydrate, lipid, and also protein with balance number. Yeah. So the daily diet should consist all of those biomolecules except nucleic acid. Nucleic acid, we can synthesize all of the nucleic acid, yeah, in our cells. So we don't take nucleic acid, it's not a problem. 80% of mammals' energy, yeah, that is processed in liver and heart. Our liver and our heart consume many energy. Why? Heart, of course, yeah. Heart, our heart is always beating, day and night. Yeah. Even though when we are asleep, our heart should beat. If stop, yeah, then game over. And liver also consume many energy because liver is the metabolic center. Detoxification occur in the liver. Many synthesis, important molecule synthesis occur in the liver. Because of that, liver play an important role. And the liver abnormality can lead to many disease, for example, like cirrhosis, hepatitis, and other. Are supply from fatty acid oxidation. Hibernating animals such as brown grizzly bear, migrating birds, they count on lipid as their main energy sources. So that's why like a bear, they consume many feces because in order to extract the food, the lipid in the food. So birds are also a migrating bird. The diet mainly consists of fish because fish consists many healthy lipid in the fish. So that's why fish is an important aspect in diet. Yeah, because for example, like omega-3, fatty acid, yeah. Many omega-3 fatty acid contain in fish. Fat is an efficient form of energy storage. So advantage of fat compared to polysaccharide. So first, you have to understand the concept of energy. For example, like I have a carbon atom. This carbon atom can present in reduced form and also oxidized form. For example, like methane, CH4. CH4 is a reduced form of carbon. It contains high energy. If the hydrogen atom release, the bond that is cut will release the energy. So if we have a methane and then we oxidize, we will get first carbon monoxide, CO. From carbon monoxide, we will get carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide is the oxidized form of carbon. Carbon methane is the reduced form of carbon. Reduced high energy. oxidized, low energy. So like a sugar, sugar is partly oxidized. So if you took sugar molecule, you will get carbon, you will get hydrogen, so it reduced. But however, there are some hydrogen attached to it. So it partly, already partly oxidized. But if you take a fatty acid molecule, it contains very small amount of oxygen. So in this long chain, carbon long chain, the oxygen only available in two oxygen atom at the end point, carboxyl group. So this is a highly reduced molecule. More energy per carbon atom due to more reduced carbon atom condition. Less water because of its nonpolar properties. Less water, so for the metabolism, we can make more energy because hydrolysis is a reaction in which it will release energy. So glucose and glycogen are short-term energy sources. So if we have glucose, if we have glycogen, then we will use these two molecules, glucose and glycogen, as energy sources. But however, in the event of lack glucose and glycogen, for example, like fasting condition, we will shift the energy sources from carbohydrate into fat. So because glucose is water soluble and rapid transport, so it used as main energy sources. Lipid is storage energy sources. Fat are for long-term energy supply in months. Water insoluble, slow transport, and efficient storage. So in order for us to remove the excess fat in our body, it's not easy. So for example, if we study about glycogen at the previous meeting, so for example, like today you eat a large amount of glucose, then the glucose will be converted into glycogen. So we have glycogen day one. And the next day, we eat more glucose. So we have glycogen day two. At the third day, we take a fasting. The degradation to take energy will be done in at the first day glycogen. So the second day glycogen will just stay for storage. But in lipid, it's not like that. So for example, like the first day you eat many lipid, then your body will synthesize fat for the first day. The next day you synthesize more lipid. So you will have a second layer of lipid in your body. The third day you do fasting, yeah, or you starving. Which lipid that will be degraded? That's the last day lipid or the second day lipid. How about the first day? No, you cannot access the first day because first day, second day, third day, and if you need energy, third day will be degraded first, and then second day, and then last is first day. So if we every day we always pile up fat, and we never do exercise, sport exercise or fasting, then you will have lipid from last year or from years ago. Yeah, because all of those lipid are never degrade. And the more you store lipid, the negative reaction of lipid is a rancidity reaction. So for example, like you store a cooking oil in your kitchen for a long time, it will become rancid. It will take up bad smells, yeah, rancid. And if lipid become rancid, our body enzyme cannot digest those lipids. And that will become a problem because it will be very difficult for you to take out all of those rancid lipid from your body. Yeah, how can we reverse the reaction with antioxidant? Antioxidant can reverse the action of rancid lipid. Because that is an oxidation reaction. So we have to use antioxidant. Okay, next, fat catabolism and anabolism. So I already talked previously about catabolism and anabolism. Catabolism is a term of degradation. Anabolism is a term of synthesis. So in lipid, we have catabolism or degradation, and we have anabolism or synthesis. Yeah. Fatty acid catabolism or degradation produce acetyl CoA and reduce form of energy, NADH. And then reaction site in animals, human, and it's in mitochondria, but in plant it occur in peroxisomes. Fatty acid anabolism or synthesis need acetyl CoA and malonyl CoA. Where we can get acetyl CoA? Actually, acetyl CoA, we need so many acetyl CoA. Malonyl CoA, we need just a small portion of malonyl CoA, only about 5%. And where we can get acetyl CoA? You can get acetyl CoA if you have many glucose. Yeah, if you eat many carbohydrate, you eat many protein, you will have acetyl CoA, and the acetyl CoA will be converted into lipid. That's why previously I say, yeah, acetyl CoA will be converted into lipid. Need reduced form of energy, NADPH. Where we get NADPH from? Pentose phosphate pathway. Okay, and the reaction site in animal cytosol or plant chloroplast. Okay, fatty acid sources from food, yeah. Oil, butter, cheese, nuts. Inner part of animal, for example, like intestine, liver, yeah, eye, brain, yeah, contain high amount of lipid and cholesterol. That way it is unhealthy to eat the internal organ of animals. But in Indonesia, yeah, the internal organ of animal is a popular to make traditional dishes. Yeah. Like in Sumatra, they cook brain of cow or a goat. Yeah, it contain very high amount of cholesterol actually. But yeah, they say it's delicious. Yeah, so and also fat synthesis in the liver, then transport to another tissue. Over intake of carbohydrate will be transformed into fat in the liver. Yeah. Okay, this is fatty acid sources. Lipid absorption in intestine. I already talked about this in our first lecture. I hope you recall what I talked previously. So this is I will not explain this in details, yeah, because I already talked about this. Yeah, the main point is all of the lipid that we eat will be converted into micelle, and then micelle will be absorbed by micelle will be digested by lipase in our intestine. Lipase is synthesized by pancreas. Pancreas will give lipase that will digest the lipid in micelle. And free fatty acid, glycerol, and also cholesterol will be absorbed in intestine and become kilomicron. Kilomicron will be circulating in our blood vessel. Why do lipid insoluble in water? Lipid degradation and absorption. So lipase will transform triacylglycerol or fat and oil in our food become micelles. And it will cut the TAG become DAG or MAG. And also will make a free fatty acid and glycerol. All of the simple molecule will enter the blood vessel in the form of kilomicron. And then the kilomicron will be absorbed by, for example, like our muscle, our adipose tissue, our liver. Yeah, many organs will take up kilomicron. And in adipose tissue, the free fatty acid from kilomicron will be converted back into triacylglycerol and stored in adipose tissue. So this is the hormone that will mobilize the triacylglycerol. So there is a hormone called hormone sensitive lipase. So if our body excrete lipase, this HSL will be activated and it will cut meningkat triacylglycerol ya in our adiposit, and triacylglycerol will enter the bloodstream and supply the fatty acid in our body. So glycerol and triglycerols. Okay. From this part, I will move again to whiteboard, yeah, because I hope you will understand easily from the schemes. Okay, I will erase this first. Okay, so we will start from food. Yeah, food in intestine. Or maybe not food. Yeah. We already talked about this at the previous lecture. So we will start. Okay, Pam. I think food is no problem. Yeah, food no problem. Yeah, food. Okay, so in the food we have free fatty acid or fatty acid. Yes, fatty acid, and then glycerol. And then cholesterol. Okay. First, we will talk about catabolism. Okay. Fatty acid will take up. Yeah, fatty acid in our cell will move. Okay. Fatty acid will move to enter mitochondria. Maybe I'll type here. Mitochondria. Okay. Fatty acid will enter mitochondria and it will be converted into acetyl-CoA. Okay, it will be converted into acetyl-CoA. The reaction is called as beta oxidation. Okay, beta oxidation will convert free fatty acid into acetyl-CoA. This reaction will give ATP plus not ATP, sorry, NADH plus FADH2. Okay. Acetyl-CoA will enter what we know as Krebs cycle. Krebs cycle. Okay, acetyl-CoA will enter Krebs cycle. Then Krebs cycle will give CO2 will come out from Krebs cycle, and also energy in the form of ATP. ATP. Okay. Energy will come out in the form of ATP. Next, Krebs cycle also produce NADH and FADH2. This NADH and FADH2 will enter. Will enter the electron transfer chain. Electron transfer chain reaction. will enter the electron transfer chain reaction to be converted into ATP. And ATP is energy. So in the case we need energy, yeah, the reaction is like this. How about the glycerol? Okay, I will use a red color. Okay, this is mitochondria, okay? How about the glycerol? Glycerol will enter the cell and converted into glyceraldehyde triphosphate. Glyceraldehyde triphosphate. This molecule will enter the glycolysis and become acetyl-CoA. Glycolysis, glycolysis. Okay. So this is the connection between, and this reaction happen in cytosol, cytosol or cytoplasm. Okay, this is the degradation reaction of lipid. So in case, yeah, as I said previously, how about cholesterol? Cholesterol do not degrade. Yeah, do not degrade into energy. So you cannot degrade cholesterol. Okay, this is happen in normal condition. Yeah. Normal condition. Okay. So how about if we get fasting? Yeah. Sorry. This is in normal condition if you eat some fat. But the excess fat, how in the case if you eat excess fat? Yeah. So this is normal condition. In the case of excess fat, I will use color green, blue. Yeah, I will use blue. Okay, this is the condition if you don't get excess fat, that you use fat as energy. So in the case of excess fat, fatty acid will go into an organ known as fatty acid, and glycerol will be combined. Fatty acid and glycerol will be combined into fat. Okay. Fatty acid and glycerol will be combined into fat. This reaction happen in oleosome, adipose tissue, oleosome. This reaction happen in adipose tissue, oleosome. Okay, yeah. So I will make a note in here. Black line is for normal condition, yeah. Black line is normal. Okay, red. Oh, not red, blue, yeah, blue. Blue line is the case of excess fat. Okay. Okay, just so black line is for normal and blue line is the metabolism for excess fat. Yeah, in the case you eat many fat and oil in your diet. Okay. So you will have this black reaction. The blue reaction. So how about in the case of you eat many carbohydrate or protein from food. So, in the case you eat many carbohydrate, sugar or glucose, glucose. In the case you eat many glucose in your diet, glucose. Okay. In the case you eat many glucose in your diet, this glucose, okay, I will use a different color. I will use green color this time. In the case you eat many glucose, glucose will be converted into glycerol dietary phosphate through the reaction of glycolysis. This is also glycolysis. Yeah, glycolysis. Glycolysis will continue to make acetyl CoA. So in here, and then, however, the acetyl CoA. I think I have to repair this. Okay. Okay. In order to make it clear. This is acetyl CoA. Still CoA, okay. Acetyl CoA will enter the mitochondria and green color, okay, green color. Okay. Sorry, mistake. Okay, but if you eat many glucose, you eat excess glucose. We don't talk about the normal glucose. For example, like you eat so many rice, bread, and others. Some rice, of course, we already talked previously, it will enter the Krebs cycle. But, however, some of the acetyl-CoA will be converted into fatty acid. Some will be sent, this acetyl-CoA, into fatty acid. Fatty acid. And this fatty acid will be converted into some of the acetyl CoA will be converted into fatty acid, and the fatty acid will be sent into the oleosome to make adipose, to make fat. Glyceraldehyde also will be supplied here to make the glycerol. Yeah, this reaction known as fatty acid synthesis. Here we have fatty acid synthesis. And this happened in smooth ER. RE, reticulum endoplasma. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, I will make some line again to differentiate. So. Okay. What if you took many protein? The reaction also the same, yeah. If you eat many protein, some of the protein also will just connected directly to acetyl-CoA. So the protein will just connected directly to acetyl-CoA. So here I will give notes, excess. Oh, not yellow, not red. Excess carbohydrate. Or protein. Okay. Yeah, in the case you eat excess carbohydrate or protein, it's same. So there are no use if we eat many protein. You will not get many muscle cells unless you do exercise. If you eat many protein but you don't do exercise, then you will get fat as the result. So this is the important aspect also if you don't eat many protein. Okay, I'm sorry, this is maybe because we talk about food, not protein, yeah, but amino acid. Because all of the protein in our diet will be converted into amino acid. Okay, amino acid. So we don't talk about the conversion of protein to amino acid because we already talked previously. And what bad is the and what bad is also if you took many protein or glucose, some of the acetyl-CoA will be converted into cholesterol as well. Into cholesterol. This also happen in smooth ER. Okay, so this is the reaction, all of the reactions, yeah, in our body. So how about this cholesterol? Cholesterol will, in normal condition, yeah, so it's not related with diet, but the cholesterol will be converted into in out of the smooth ER for cell membrane. Second, bile acid. Folic acid or bile acid. Three, steroid hormone. Four, vitamin D. Okay. So like this, cholesterol will supply for cell membrane, folic acid, bile acid, steroid hormone, and vitamin D. Okay, this is the complete catabolism and anabolism reaction in our body. This is summarized. Actually, this is summarized all of our lecture today. Yeah. Okay. Okay, I will continue again to the slides. Okay, we will have a discussion at the end of this lecture, but I hope you already take notes about this, or you can screen share now before I back to the you can screenshot this whiteboard because before I get back to the PowerPoint. Okay, already took screenshot. Okay. Stop share. Okay, I will back to the PowerPoint again. Ah, I think I missed something. Okay. I missed something. We haven't talked about fasting condition. Yeah. Fasting condition. We have fat in here. Okay, you see we have fat. So how is the fate of this fat? What will happen to the fat molecule in here? Yeah. If you do fasting, okay, I will use different color again. What color can we use? Purple. Okay, we will use purple color. Okay, in fasting condition, our body will convert fat into fatty acid and glycerol. Fatty acid will go to mitochondria, yeah, to make energy. So here and here, 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 and here. Okay. Yes, so in fasting condition, how about the glycerol? Glycerol also same, it will be back to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. This is fasting condition. Yes, so in fasting condition, we will have this reaction. Okay, sorry, I forget. I miss one important reaction, yeah, fasting condition. Fasting condition. Fasting. Yeah. Condition. Okay. Yeah, I think the reaction already complete. Yeah, we have a normal condition. In the case we eat normal, we eat carbohydrate, we eat lipid, yeah, and we eat protein in the normal condition, the black reaction will occur. In the case you eat many glucose, you eat many amino acid, many protein, the green reaction will be happen. But in the case you eat excess fat, you eat many fat, the blue reaction will be happen. In the case you do fasting, yeah, the purple reaction will be happen. How about starvation? Starvation is a protein metabolism. We will discuss later. In starvation, you have already lost your all of the fat storage. Yeah, so we don't talk about fat again. So here, there are also one other important reaction. If we eat many fat and also we eat and also we do fasting, our body will produce high amount of acetyl CoA. This is very, very high, so the Krebs cycle cannot handle, so some acetyl CoA will spill over here, and the spillover acetyl CoA in fasting condition will be converted into ketone bodies. We call ketone bodies. Sorry, this is only in fasting condition. In fasting condition, it will be converted into ketone bodies. Ketone bodies. Ketone bodies happen in outside of the cell, and some ketone bodies, yeah, will be used as energy. And the other will be converted into acetone. 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 And this acetone will be secreted in our breath. Yeah, breath. In our breath. Breath. Okay, will be converted. Breath. Okay. Yeah. Okay. This is the complete reaction. Okay, this is fasting condition. Okay, I almost forget this. Yep, this is an important reaction. Yes. Okay, I think this is already complete. Yeah, please take a screenshot again. Okay. Yeah, that's why when someone fasting, he or she, the breath smell will become different. That because there is acetone in he or in she or his breath, yeah, her or his breath. Okay, next about the glycerol enter glycolysis. We already talk about this. Okay. One more reaction. Yeah, sometimes there are one or miss reaction. Okay, so when we degrade fat, we produce NADH and FADH too. But what happen if we want to synthesis fat? If you want to synthesis fat, of course you need energy. Where did you get the energy? In the case you eat excess amount of glucose, of course you will have what is called with pentose phosphate pathway. This is will make ribose plus NADPH. And NADPH. NADPH will be used as energy sources for fatty acid synthesis for here. Okay, this is reaction called pentose phosphate pathway. Okay. Yeah, we have so many reaction. Okay, so NADPH will be used as energy for fatty acid biosynthesis. Fatty acid degradation resulting NADPH, NADH, and FADH too. Fatty acid synthesis need NADPH. So different molecule. Okay, do not mix these two molecules together. Okay. So back again to PowerPoint slides. Fatty acid transport to mitochondria. Fatty acid transport to mitochondria happen via occur via some protein channels. This protein channel need transporter. Short fatty acid freely diffuse across membrane. For example, like less than 12 carbon atom fatty acid, like lauric acid, it happened freely through diffusion. But for longer fatty acid, like amyristic acid, palmitic acid, oleic acid, and more, it will have to go to transporter, yet include facilitated dispersion or active transport. The transporter in mitochondria is carnitine. This compound is a very important compound, and you will hear many of milk that is aimed for bodybuilder contain carnitine. Bodybuilder, people who want to reduce their weight, the milk will contain carnitine. Why? Because carnitine here is needed. Carnitine is needed to transport acetyl-CoA or acyl-CoA from cytosol or cytoplasm into mitochondrial matrix for further digestion into acetyl-CoA. So carnitine is very important molecule. That's why some milk contain this carnitine. Okay, next fatty acid transport to mitochondria. First esterification into coenzyme A, formation of thioester bond, using ATP, esterification to carnitine and transport, and so on. Okay, this you can read about this later. Next, fatty acid oxidation stages. Oxidation stage of fatty acid consists of four step oxidation stage. Okay. There are three stage the fatty acid oxidation four step. Four step of fatty acid oxidation: dehydrogenation, hydration, dehydrogenation again, and transfer. I will not discuss this in details because you are not from biochemistry, So I think for veterinary medicine, the importance of lipid metabolism is for the pathology of lipid. So the relation of lipid metabolism with various disease. So I will just skip this. However, you can read about this later, but in the test also we do will not asking details about two details about this for veterinary medicine. Yeah, and about the energy, you will get 8 molecule of acetyl-CoA, 7 molecule of FADH2, 7 molecule of NADH. With the conversion rate of 1 NADH become 2.5 ATP, 1 FADH become 1.5 ATP. So if you count the final energy, you will get 108 ATP per 1 fatty acid molecule. Compare this to glucose. One glucose only produce 32 ATP. That less than half of the ATP from fatty acid. So yes, if you eat fat and you eat carbohydrate, then you should eat with the half of the amount of carbohydrate. For example, like, yeah, I want to do ketogenic diet. Today it's very popular. Some people use ketogenic diet to reduce their body weight. They don't eat carbohydrate. They only eat protein and fat. In this case, you will have to reduce the size of your eating portion because the fat calorie is much higher than carbohydrate calorie. Oxidation of unsaturated fatty acid. Okay, until now, we already talked about the saturated fatty acid. How about the unsaturated fatty acid? So if you ask me which one is healthier, saturated fatty acid or unsaturated fatty acid, of course, natural unsaturated fatty acid is much healthier than saturated fatty acid. So cheese, unsaturated fatty acid or normal, yeah, natural, is very healthy. Next. Saturated fatty acid. And trans unsaturated fatty acid is very unhealthy. Okay. So for unsaturated fatty acid degradation process, we need two extra enzyme. First isomerase and second is reductase. This is the reaction process. I will not go in detail about this reaction process. You can read about this later. Okay. Next, we also have odd number unsaturated fatty acid. Yeah. Is it good for our diet? Yes. Any unsaturated fatty acid is healthier than saturated fatty acid. Cheese, but in cheese form. If you eat trans, that's very unhealthy. But in the nature, we cannot find trans unsaturated. We get trans unsaturated if we eat processed food, such as cooking oil that is used repeatedly. Okay, this is the result. I will pass. Next, about the bear. Yeah. Bear find the highest quality food wherever they live. Grizzly bear can eat for 20 hours straight and then they took hibernation. Yeah, a single polar bear can spend 300,000 square kilometer, yeah, the size of UK and Ireland combined. When hibernating, a bear will lose up to 2/3 of its body weight and only breathe 1 in a minute for saving their energy. The sloth bear has lost 2 of its front teeth and has flap which cover its nostril so that it can suck up its favorite food, termite, more effectively. Yeah, because the diet consists of termite. Yeah, so this is the key adaptation for those bear is fat. Yeah, fat and oil. Their diet mainly consists of fat and oil. Yeah, but however, today we also study about what is called with nutrigenomics. So what you eat also depend on who you are. For example, like people from Eskimo people live in the North Pole. Yeah, their diet consists mainly of fat, but none of them have cholesterol disease. Why? Because their genes already accustomed to take only food and only fat and oil in their diet. But us who live in Ecuador, we get vegetarian diet in our daily diet. Vegetarian food, we eat plant-based food. So if you convert this plant-based food today in, for example, like Western-style food, yeah, that contain only small amount of rice, high amount of meat, fat, and protein, and very, very low amount of plant-based food, like a salad or something, very low amount. Yeah, in the long term, yeah, you will get atherosclerosis disease, stroke, coronary artery disease, because our gene already accustomed to a plant-based food, yeah, for us who live in Ecuador. I think the normal diet of people, Malay people, yeah, people from Indonesia, Malaysia, yeah, include the Malaysian people, descendants from Indian people or descendants from the Chinese people, southern Chinese people also, they consume rice, yeah, as their main staple food, not fat. Yeah, but so that's important in our diet also to include plant-based food and especially unprocessed food. Because unprocessed food contains all of the nutrition in that we need for our daily life. Unsaturated food also contain in many of the fruits, yeah. For example, like avocado, chocolate, cacao bean. If you take cacao bean consists high amount of vitamin C, consists high amount of antioxidant, cacao bean. But if you process this cacao bean into chocolate, yeah, you will lose all of its vitamin C. You will lose all of its antioxidant, all of its enzymes. Yeah, and you will get only carbohydrate, only sugar, and chocolate become unhealthy. So that's processed food. Okay, next, ketogenesis. Occur in starvation, yeah, fasting, and excessive exercise. When someone excessive exercise, yeah, he or she will break down many fat and produce hormone sensitive lipase. This hormone will mobilize lipid to all of our body. So in the case we do fasting, starving, and also actually this is fasting is not precise in here. It should be not starving, but fasting. Fasting is more precise. Excessive exercise also, it will mobilize fat to our whole body. Yeah, I already talked about ketone bodies earlier, include acetone, acetoacetate, and beta-hydroxybutyrate. This is the reaction. Why we produce ketone bodies? Because our brain cell only can use glucose and ketone bodies as energy sources. So our brain cell cannot use fat as the energy sources. Yeah, that's why if you don't have glucose, ketone bodies will use as energy sources for the brain cell. But the excess amount of ketone bodies will make up acetone, and acetone will be take out from our breath. That's why if someone heavy exercise, someone fasting, then the breath smell will be different due to acetone concentration. If someone consume alcohol, yeah, alcohol also will be converted into acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde and acetone smell are similar, so that's why sometimes mix up. Okay, this is the reaction of ketogenesis. Yeah. Involve triacylglycerol from our adipose or fat cells break down into fatty acid send into bloodstream, in the bloodstream, then the fatty acid will be uptake by any cells, and then the cell will use the fatty acid as energy. In the case in the liver, fatty acid will be converted some into glucose through gluconeogenesis. This is overview of fatty acid degradation or beta oxidation and fatty acid biosynthesis. Okay, you can read about this. Yeah, anyway, biosynthesis of fatty acid in our body, all of the synthesis fatty acid is saturated. That's why saturated fatty acid is non-essential fatty acid. Saturated fatty acid non-essential. Why non-essential? Because we can synthesize in our body. But unsaturated fatty acid, we cannot synthesize. So that's why sometimes unsaturated fatty acid also called with essential fatty acid, such as omega 3, 6, or 9 fatty acids. Okay, this is overview. I will skip this. Okay, I will skip this as well. Yeah, you can read this later. Okay, this is important protein in fatty acid synthesis. Yeah. Anyway, if you want to degrade fatty acid, catabolize fatty acid, you need four key enzyme. But for synthesis fatty acid, you only need one enzyme. This one enzyme synthesize catalyze four reaction. The reverse reaction of the degradation. Okay, you can read about this later. I will upload these slides on new LMS so you can read later. I think the translation is not yet complete, but I will upload after I finish the translation. Okay, where is the location of the metabolism of fatty acid? First, in animal cell, yeah. The key places in synthesis of amino acid first is cytosol. Cytosol for NADPH production via pentose phosphate pathway, malic enzyme. If NADPH per NADP high, we will have fatty acid and also sterol synthesis. If low, we will have degradation. Mitochondria. Fatty acid oxidation. Endoplasmic reticulum. Cholesterol synthesis. Fatty acid synthesis. Yeah. Elongation, desaturation. In plant cell, please remember that plant cell do not do fasting. That's why there are no fatty acid oxidation in plant cell. Because plant cell don't do exercise. They don't do fasting. They only accumulate carbohydrate and fat. Some plant contain high amount of carbohydrate such as sugar beet, yeah, or sugar cane. They contain high amount of sugar. Yeah, many fruit like as mango, grapes, they contain high amount of sugar. Some food contain high amount of fat like as avocado, durian, yeah, contain high amount of fat. That's why people with high cholesterol concentration, it's not good for them to consume durian. Durian, and also we have a, like a local plant like a jackfruit and cempedak, yeah, not good for high cholesterol condition. Yeah, overall synthesis of palmitic acid, yeah, I will skip this. Yeah, energy in transport of acetyl-CoA. This is related to Krebs cycle. I will skip this. Elongation of carbon chain. Yes. So this reaction happen in plants. Okay. So I will have to underline. Yeah. This reaction happen in plant because previously I state in animal we can only synthesize saturated fatty acid. So until here, yeah. Okay. Animal can do. Animal okay. Animal. Okay, but from here downward only plant can do. Only plant can do here. Okay, only plant can do. So in plant can synthesize longer saturated fatty acid from stearate. It also can synthesize oleate that will be this is not animal, this is human. Okay, please allow me to no eraser. Wait, I need eraser. Yeah, no problem. Okay. Ah. Okay. Yeah. So human. I'm sorry. This is mistake. Yeah. This should be human. I mix human with animal. But animal can do this reaction. Yeah. Here and here. Me and this can be done in animal. Such as in goat, yeah, they will synthesize longer fatty acid, but however it is saturated. Longer saturated fatty acid animal can synthesize, but longer unsaturated fatty acid, animal also can synthesize this, yeah. But plant and fishes, yeah, fish actually. Okay, animal, plant, and fish. Yeah, fish also can synthesize this. Fish. Fish also can synthesize long unsaturated fatty acid. That's why plant and fish-based diet is healthy because fish contain high amount of linoleate, yeah, and other unsaturated fatty acid. Okay, this is the resum. I will just pass the resum. You can read resum. Regulation of lipid metabolism. Okay, so there are two huge separation. First is fatty acid synthesis. Second, fatty acid oxidation. I will talk about the oxidation first. Oxidation only controlled by malonyl-CoA. In the case we have high amount of malonyl-CoA, then the fatty acid oxidation will stop. But in normal condition, we don't have high amount of malonyl-CoA. Why? Because for example, like you eat high amount of carbohydrate, then your blood glucose level will rise. High blood glucose level will induce insulin release by pancreas. Insulin release will activate phosphatase. Phosphatase will activate ACC or acetyl ACP carboxylase. ACC will turn up acetyl-CoA into malonyl-CoA. So you will have high amount of malonyl-CoA if you eat many glucose in your diet. Yeah, in this condition, the fatty acid degradation will stop because you already have glucose. Why you need to degrade carbohydrate? But in the case you not you already eat, for example, like you eat at the 6 in the morning and in 12 on the noon you don't eat something, so the blood glucose level will decrease, and then pancreas will release glucagon. Glucagon will stop the activity of ACC, so the malonyl-CoA will stop being produced, and malonyl-CoA will decrease, and then degradation of fatty acid will occur. Okay, and what are the key organ in lipid metabolism? First, of course, liver. Liver carry out many important metabolic pathway. We will follow the number in here. First, muscle cell. Protein degradation in muscle cell yield glucogenic amino acid. These amino acids will be sent into the liver. In the liver, the nitrogen from the amino acid will be converted into urea and excreted in urine from the kidney. While the carbon chain will enter the citric acid cycle. Enter the citric acid cycle to release phosphoenolpyruvate that will undergo glycolysis to make glucose. Glucose can be exported into the brain to make energy in the brain. While the lack of oxaloacetate, because in the case of we only consume protein and fat, we don't consume carbohydrate, especially in ketogenic diet. Lack of oxaloacetate prevent acetyl-CoA entry into the citric acid cycle. So the acetyl-CoA will go to acetoacetyl-CoA and make ketone body. Ketone body will be used as energy sources by our brain, but some excess ketone body also will go to kidney and end up in urine, and some will go to our breath. In the case of prolonged fasting, and the fat cells, adipose cells, also will release fatty acid to be converted into acetyl-CoA. Okay, next we will talk about cholesterol. Cholesterol is synthesized from acetyl-CoA in the case we have large amount of energy, and it can be converted into bile salt, vitamin D, as I stated earlier. Also, the cholesterol itself is used in the cell membrane. Cholesterol also converted into progesterone that can be converted into glucocorticoid. Yeah. Many of the glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid is a growth hormone. And some progesterone will be converted into androgen. What is androgen? It's testosterone. And testosterone converted into estrogen. Estrogen will be excreted from our body. So the differences between male and female in here. In male, we will accumulate testosterone. So the cholesterol converted into testosterone. Testosterone accumulate, and then some part of testosterone will be converted into estrogen and take out from the body. Small amount. But in women, reaction is contrary. So in women, cholesterol is converted into testosterone. Testosterone converted into estrogen. This reaction occur rapidly. So women will accumulate estrogen. Estrogen will take out, will secrete from the body once in monthly. Yeah, into the monthly cycle, in the monthly cycle in female. So that's why these differences in metabolic process resulting in male and female sexes. Yeah, but however, today there are many LGBT movement. Yeah, I don't know in Malaysia, but in Indonesia we oppose the LGBT movement. Yeah, why? Because we think that it will destroy our nations. Yeah, you can imagine if all the people will do the LGBTs, and then nobody will have kids, nobody will have children, because male will just like the male and female with female. There are no next generations. So that's why in Indonesia it is prohibited, this LGBT movement. So why the LGBT movement happened? One of the factor is the abuse of drugs. Drugs abuse will mess up your hormone. Drug abuse mess up your hormone. If you mess up with your hormones, then you mess up with your feelings. Because your feelings is a hormone. Why do you happy now? Because you have serotonin. You have endorphin. Then you will be happy. Why you are sad? Because your blood lack amount of endorphin, lack amount of serotonin, low amount of dopamine. That's why you are being sad and depressed. So how about the free feeling? That's because of cortisol. How about the angry and fear feeling? That is because of the adrenaline. All of those are hormones. Why male like the female? Because they have testosterone. Why female like male? Because they have estrogens. When you mix up this hormone, ruin. Why? Because for example, like testosterone. Testosterone is a female hormone. It induces male characteristic. What is male characteristic? It's power. So the abuse drugs in testosterone derivative, for example, like prednisolone, dihydrotestosterone. Some athlete, especially a bodybuilder athlete, cycling athlete, marathon athlete, some of them use prednisolone or dihydrotestosterone. They inject into their muscle cell in order their muscle cell produce more cells so they have more power. In the long term, their body metabolism cannot metabolize the excess testosterone because of the drug. The excess testosterone will be converted into estrogen. Okay, so I said previously in here you can see excess testosterone converted into estrogen. But you can only release estrogen in male small amount daily. So in one point you will have high accumulation of estrogen. That's why some people with abuse drugs, especially for the bodybuilder, they will become a very macho on the outside, macho on the outside because of testosterone, but feminine inside. Why feminine inside? Because estrogen accumulation. So in Jakarta last year or 2 years ago, I forget, I think last year, the police caught many LGBT activists, male, in gym, because many of them use that. So it will be different. In normal male, if we see female, then we will attract, we will like the female. But if you use testosterone abuse in the long term, you male, but you will like to see the other male. So that's hormone. It's not good. And it's dangerous. Okay, the negative effect also, the steroid hormone abuse will induce cancers because steroid hormone induce cell growth, as I said previously, muscle cell growth. But if those growth cannot control, then you will get cancers. If the injection also not precise, for example, you not inject your muscle cell, but the injection goes through your white blood cell, then you will have leukemia. So it's very dangerous for a drug abuse. Okay, this is cholesterol. Okay, we will skip this. LDL, I said previously, HDL. LDL is a bad cholesterol. HDL is a good cholesterol. Later I will translate this so you will read more clearly. This is the cholesterol metabolism. Okay, so there are many factors that will increase LDL concentration in our blood. Such as high cholesterol intake, hereditary factor, genetic factors, food factors, and then cigarette smoking, age, sexes. Male have higher risk of cardiovascular disease than female. And then estrogen concentration, menopause female have high risk of cardiovascular compared to productive female. And then also sedentary lifestyle, like now maybe we tend to only see the monitor, reduce physical activity. That's not good for our cardiovascular system. Okay, cholesterol biosynthesis. Okay, that's all for the lecture today. I will stop.